What is going on, everybody, and welcome back to another good game of football here in Sky Bet League One. Carlisle United versus Derby. Of course, it finished 2-0 to Derby County, but a really good game to watch. A few players to highlight. I thought Sam Lavelle, Jordan Gibson and Finn Back were absolutely excellent today. I thought the atmosphere was fantastic from both sides. I think I put it on Twitter. The amount of Carlisle fans doing the waterworks could be maybe good to Derby. And they would probably have sold a few hundred more tickets, if not even, to be fair, sold out the waterworks. Always money for the club, but that's a debate for other games. But maybe for the likes of Bolton, Blackpool, clubs like that coming, like Chowton, clubs like that coming to Bunton Park, maybe an opportunity for them to have the waterworks. The Blues had the chance here, and we just didn't fill it out. The rest of the stadium was pretty full. There was 11,180, and credit 1,533 Derby fans as well. We'll ignore that slight bit of fan trouble towards the end, though. But moving into the game, then Carlisle had made an unchanged lineup, which I don't think anyone was really surprised about. And that's probably our lineup that we're gonna continue with, apart from maybe one position, which we'll get into a little bit later in the video. But Carlisle started really fast. Carlisle had a really good start to the game. Some nice pieces of play early on in the game. Derby had a good chance quite early as well. Sam Lavelle made an excellent tackle just to block that out. Sam Lavelle really growing into that Carlisle United shirt in the centre of defence. And then, unfortunately, a lack of communication between Sam Lavelle and Huntington, I believe it was. And the crosses came in. And it's a finished off by James Collins to make it 1-0. And a nice touch with Derby's celebration to honour their goalkeeper, Josh Vickers, who I'm not 100% sure on the situation, but it was a nice touch from the Derby players. But anyway, Carlisle 1-0 down. I don't think we deserve to be 1-0 down at the moment in time that we were 1-0 down, but that's football at the end of the day. And then it looked like Mellish went straight into the midfield after that, and we went into a 4-3-3 formation. And then Finn Back has put a tackle in on Mendes Lang. Now, Mendes Lang is absolutely rapid. Some player he is, I must say. But for me, I thought Finn Back got very lucky. I thought it was a penalty on Mendes Lang, to be perfectly honest. But then Gibson had a cross as well, and I haven't seen a replay, so I can't comment, but Paul Simpson was quite adamant that it was a handball. But I can't say anything because I'm not 100% sure. And then we had a few free kicks. We had eight in total. And we had like three back-to-back in that first half in Moxon, and we were struggling to get them over the wall before Jordan Gibson had a really good shot. The keepers parried it. He sort of spilled it against the crossbar, inches. And then Jordan Gibson, a couple of minutes after that, down the wing again. Hit sort of a low crossover shot. I'm not really sure. It just went wide. Really good play from Gibson, though, to keep the close control. And then just literally a couple of minutes after that as well, Jordan Gibson again with another good chance, forcing the save out of their goalkeeper. And just again, another couple of minutes after that, Luke Plange hits the post. Really good effort from Plans, just outside the box, comes off the post, goes out for a goal kick. And that was really the first half. Now, it was a really positive half from Carlisle United. I think we've gone into League One week by week really well. You've seen improvements week on week. Unfortunately, as we'll get into later, we keep giving away quite soft goals. Port Vale's a good example of like a goal that's like, what on earth's going on? We'll get to another one later on in this thing. But I thought it was a very positive half from Carlisle, despite the scoreline. I think we were quite harshly 1-0 down at half-time, to be perfectly honest. I don't think Derby created that much. It was more of a smash-and-grab performance. And Carlisle played very well in that first half. Unfortunately, we didn't match it in the second half. Derby didn't massively improve. It was sort of smash and grab performance from them, I thought. They'll be very happy to go away with a 2-0 victory, I think. But Carlisle didn't match that attention into the second half. We didn't do too well. They had a corner where I thought Anderson got very lucky. Their player got ahead on it and put it into the side netting. But Anderson came out for him, was nowhere near the ball. And I thought he got very lucky that that went wide. I was very impressed with our substitutes. Ryan Edmondson came on, Joe Garland came on, Jack Robinson came on, and Terry Blade. Now, the first subs was John Mellish and Luke Plange. Now, Mellish went off for Terrier Blade and Plange for Joe Garn. I thought that was really attacking. I was quite impressed with me seeing that. It was nice to see Jack Robinson get some minutes in replacement for Jack Armour. And it was nice that Sean Maguire stayed on. I'd really like to see Sean Maguire and Joe Garner start a game together. I think that'll be a very interesting partnership. But Sean Maguire then came off for Ryan Edmondson. And I thought we won the front foot. We just didn't get the same chances that we did in the first half. We didn't create as much as we did in that first half in the second half. And that was that it was clear that we weren't sort of up for it as much as we were in the first half, if that makes sense. And then I guess we've got to talk about it. Their players got the ball. Henderson's came out for it. I have no idea what he's doing. He's went down. He's got the player. And it's a penalty. Now, I've seen one person say it wasn't a penalty. It was a definite penalty. I don't know what he's thinking there. I really don't. Their player is going nowhere with that ball to attack at our goal. And he's been took out. He's been given the penalty. It's reckless goalkeeping, in my opinion. And then, to be fair, a great penalty from James Collins, to be honest, to make it 2-0. That killed the game off. I can't really tell you what happened for the next sort of 6 minutes because the fan trouble seemed to take everyone's attention. But I think that's where the game really died off. I don't think there was much more after that. Derby County 2-0 up at that point. And when you look at it, now, I've got quite a positive hat on. It was a good game of football to watch. There was promising signs from Carlisle. Derby are a big club. Let's not get that mixed up. Derby are a very strong team. You know, they've got players like Conor Hourihan, who didn't feature today, possibly injured. They've got Mendes Lang, who's a championship player for sure. You've got Martin Waghorn, who, I mean, he went down a bit. You know, he was taking the mick with some of the things he was going down with. But, you know, the players that shouldn't be in League One. So Derby, they are a big club, and the fact that we outplayed them in that first half, yes, I know we were 1-0 down, but the fact that we outplayed them and we looked the better of the sides is a really promising thing for Carlisle. And as I said earlier in the video, I think we're slowly growing to stay in this division. We're slowly growing into the division. We're getting better week by week. We came into this game 3 unbeaten in the league. And, you know, it's a tough team to play, Derby. It's not going to get much easier next week against Wickham. I think they're a really good team as well. But the main talking point from the game, and it's going to be the goalkeeper, isn't it? You know, there's no getting around it. The goalkeeper is... I haven't been convinced with Anderson. I've been willing to give him a chance because, you know, he's Simo sees something in him. He was great against, was it Stevenage? He was really good. Or was it Lincoln? Possibly it was one of them too. He was really good. At shot stopping, you know, he had a really good game. And I'm not taking that away from him, but there's just been a couple of things that seems a bit consistent. There's a mistake there, and I know people are going to argue there's a mistake with Thomas Hawley, but for me, I would start Thomas Hawley next week against Wickham. I don't think Paul Simpson will. I think Anderson will stay. I think that team will stay unchanged. But for me, I'd like to see Thomas Hawley back in the sticks as our number one goalkeeper. But then Anderson's only had 3 or 4 games. So do you give him more of a chance? That's Paul Simpson's thing. Everyone's going to have a different opinion on it. I just think today, that was a reckless bit of goalkeeping to give away the penalty. And it killed the game off, that second goal for Derby. But that's my opinion. That's my opinion. What's your opinion? Let me know in the comments down below. Who would you start next week? But as I say, I can't see Simo changing it, if I'm going to be perfectly honest. But all in all, a promising game for Carlisle United. A game where we did play well. It means that looking at the table, that Carlisle stay in, we dropped to 19th. I believe we came to this game at 18th. We're in 19th position. And it's not a bad one, to be fair. It's not a bad one. Wickham sitting 11th, which is up next week. If you're making the trip down to Adams Park, safe journey down there. My 5-minute review will be live later on this week. But for now, I have been CUO4. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.
damn, you're the best. Put me in the ring, you'll go out in a bag. Cause I sing what I mean and I bring it to the mad light.